Now in this chapter Laws of Motion we are going to discuss the very important topic friction and frictional force, microscopic view of the friction, right? Now we are going to discuss about the frictional effect and friction in our life, its advantage. Without friction there are many happenings that we can't do. Like without friction we cannot walk, without friction we could not get cars, trucks from one place to another place. There must be sufficient friction between the tire and the road to move the car from one place to another place. Without friction, the most important thing that we cannot write on the paper using the pencil. Without friction you cannot hold many objects in your hand. Hence friction has many advantages in our life, and there are many happenings that could not possible in our life and in nature without friction. But at the same time friction has some disadvantage. It stops every moving object and hence the kinetic energy will dissipates. That means friction dissipates our energy. Hence friction has advantage and disadvantage both. Now you can see that one of the example that there is a friction between the ladder and the vertical wall, and as well as at the horizontal surface there is some friction. That's why this ladder is at the position of rest. If the friction will not exist, then this ladder cannot be at rest against the wall and the horizontal surface, right? Now you can see that a boy is moving on this horizontal surface, but if we using the slipper, actually the frictional force or friction between the slipper and the horizontal surface is reduced, and that's why the boy is not able to move on the surface. This type of event is occurring with us in day-to-day life. Sometimes we are not able to move on the wet surface. Wet surface, that means the surface on which little bit of water is there, right? It is due to the absence of sufficient friction. Hence there is a requirement of frictional force, right? Now the most important question is that what is frictional force, right? Friction is the force which arises due to the tendency of relative motion of solid surface in contact. What does it mean? Tendency of relative motion, right? In day-to-day life, you are applying some force on an object kept on the horizontal surface, but you are not able to move that object. You have applied force, but the object is not moving on the surface. If you increase the force, the object starts moving. There is a relative motion of the object on the surface. In that case, the friction force once again arises. Hence, the friction is the force which arises due to the tendency of relative motion of solid surfaces in contact, or we can say that the relative motion of solid surfaces in contact, right? There is another type of friction force which is known as viscous force. It is due to the relative motion between the adjacent layer of the moving fluid, and this type of friction force is known as viscous force in the fluid, and it will exist in the viscous fluid, right? And whenever the material elements slide against each other, then there is a friction force, right? Hence friction force will arise due to all these regions. Now we are discussing the types of friction. There are different types of friction. One is the basically dry or solid friction, which will exist when two solid surfaces in contact will have the relative motion, or there is a tendency of relative motion. And in this chapter we'll discuss in detail about the solid friction or dry friction, right? There is another friction, fluid friction, that will exist in the moving fluid due to the relative motion of adjacent layer of the moving fluid, right? Another friction is the lubricated friction. Lubricated friction is the case of fluid friction where a lubricant fluid separates two solid surfaces. Sometimes to reduce the frictional effect between two solid surfaces. We are introducing the some type of fluid between them, and the friction force will reduce at the point of contact of the two solid surfaces, right? This type of friction is known as lubricated friction. Now next one is the skin friction, right? Skin friction, when an object or a solid object or any type of object is moving through a fluid, then fluids will exert drag force on the object, and in that case the skin friction will arise. This type of friction is known as skin friction, right? Next one is the internal friction. Internal friction is the friction resisting motion between the elements making up of a solid material while it undergoes the deformation. When you apply some force on a solid object, then it can deform, and during the deformation, there will some internal friction will exist between the elements of the solid material, right? These are the different types of friction. But in this chapter, we'll discuss about the solid friction or dry friction in detail in the next sessions, right? Now we are going to discuss about the microscopic view of the frictional force. What you can see, a block is placed on this surface, and at the point of contact, what is happening, we are going to discuss. Every object which has the rough surface, that means every rough surface have small little bumps, that you can see, have very small little bumps. Magnified view of this surface, small little bumps. Hence, when this object is placed on this surface, what is happening, the small little bumps will interlock with of the two surfaces. See this interlocking, right? Hence, to move this object, first of all we have to break this interlocking, and to break this interlocking we have to apply some effort and some force, and that's why the frictional force will arise. This one is the microscopic view of the friction force, right? In the next session, we'll discuss about the dry friction or solid friction in detail in this chapter.